So, welcome back after the holidays. Today we are going to start with the chapter from the diary of Anne Frank. So now what this chapter, the diary of Anne Frank, is all about? As the name signifies, that the chapter is about from the diary. Okay, that is a girl named Anne Frank who has written a diary, and this is just an excerpt from that diary. Actually, she has written a complete book which is known as The Diary of a Young Girl, and ultimately this excerpt, which is taken from that diary, in which she has written all about her experience at the concentration camp. So what is a concentration camp? During the World War II, when there was a fight or when there was a war, and when the German was overtaken by the Nazis. And at that time, what has happened? People, they have been dragged to be sent to the concentration camps, right? And ultimately what has happened, as she is a Jewish girl, during that time, being a Jewish is a crime, okay? So ultimately she was living in a hiding place. She was living in a hiding place and just, you can say, keeping herself safe along with her family, and ultimately saved herself there for some time. She was living in an annex. Actually, she has written that book that name was The Diary of a Young Girl. It was actually in the form of diary entries. Okay, so how in the form of diary entries? That, like, with each and every date, for example, date July this, 19 this, and she has written there her diary. Okay, and what was the purpose of writing her diary? Actually, she was feeling that there was nobody with her with whom she could share her feelings with. So ultimately this book, it has turned out to be a great explanation of her experience of her life in the concentration camp and in the annex when she was living in a hiding place. Okay, so this chapter, it doesn't encapsulate the entire, you can say, the entire life of Anne Frank, but of course just a part has been taken with which you people are related. That is school life, in which she has mentioned that as children, they are fond of talking a lot. She was also talking a lot in the class, and ultimately she was being punished by Mr. Kiesing, who was her mathematics teacher. She was being punished once, and ultimately see the intelligence of the teacher, that he has not punished her by making her stand, by, you can say, spanking him, but what has happened, he has told her to write an essay on a chatterbox. You know what is a chatterbox? Okay, which the person who talks a lot. And ultimately at one time she has written an essay, then second time she has written an essay, and at the third time when she has written an essay, it was a humorous story about a duck. Okay, about a duck who has killed all the three ducklings because they were quacking a lot. And ultimately in this manner she has explained, but actually this was just a humorous side which she has presented of her life. Actually her life was not at all bed of roses. If you will read that complete book, The Diary of a Young Girl, the novel that is named as The Diary of a Young Girl, at that moment you will come to know that how difficult their life was in that hiding. First of all, they have been one of the family friends. They have, you can say, allowed her to save them from Nazis in his house. They were living in a hiding. At night, they were not be allowed to use water, even to flush out water after using toilet, because that will make noise. Because nobody in the adjoining areas, nobody in the nearby houses, nobody knew that who is living there. Nobody knew at all. They were just living in a hiding. They were not allowed to come out of their house even at during the daytime, because the door of the annex, it was not secluded one. It was not a separate one. It was attached to a shop. So ultimately, see, you can very well imagine that what kind of life it would be that she has been living with. But still, she is an example of hope. She has hope still there while living in hiding, that they knew that if they would be dragged to the concentration camp, they would not survive. Of course, she knew. And ultimately, but she was a hope. hope for all, hope for the present time people, for the future, means that in the sweerest of the situations, in the difficult of the situations, you will be able to find yourself, you can say, you will be able to find yourself in a, you can say, in the ray of hope. You can find yourself that you will still be able to succeed. And this what this small little Jewish girl, she has explained. And let me point out here that just at the age of 14 years, she was just 14 years of age when she has written her diary. And how you can very well imagine 13 or 14 years, what is the age? How young, what a tender age it is when she has written her diary of a young girl. And at that time, while writing her diary, she, it is after her death that her diary has been recovered by her father, and ultimately it was published, and it was published in the form of a novel. Actually, someone has told her father that this could be a great example of the life in hiding, because during World War II, it was giving out a number of, you can say, explanations about the life of the people in the concentration camps. And this is what she is going to explain. And this has turned out to be a great account of the life of the people in hiding. So at what a tender age she has written her diary. That was really unimaginable. This is really, and how clearly she has explained her life, how birthdays were being celebrated, how she, what on her 13th birthday, what she has got the present of a diary from her father, and ultimately how she is using. Naturally, they were also not going to school during that time because they were living in hiding. So there were no provision at all for them to be entered to the school or to join the school. So ultimately what has happened, how she has and her sister, they both have increased their knowledge with the books available. They were trying to improve their knowledge. They were trying to, you can say, enrich themselves with the knowledge. And see, this is the sincerity of her character. This is also an example for the students that even in the direst times, even in the difficult times, one should never lose hope of, and one should never be afraid of this situation. Okay, she is an example of hope. She is an example of ray of hope for all, even during the time of Holocaust. Okay, so I have talked about the word Holocaust. Okay, that World War II, during that time when Nazis, they have invaded German, during that time it was the time of Holocaust. What is Holocaust? It means deliberate killing. Deliberate killing. It is deliberate killing of a large number of people. Due to racial discrimination. Due to racial discrimination, yes, of course. Or at that time, what was there? That there was a breach between Nazis and the Germans, and during World War II, because of that, Jewish people, they have been dragged out of their houses, then they have been killed. So this is the time of Holocaust, and she of course has a ray of hope in her life during the time of Holocaust. She was believing that, of course, when all this will be over, we will be able to live a life of peace. But ultimately, that was just her bad luck that she was not able to live a life of peace. And ultimately, one day because of some secret information given by some other person, they have been dragged to the concentration camps, where other family members of his family, they have died of typhus. Typhus is a fever. And she also did not survive much longer. And after the death of Anne Frank, her diary has been recovered by her father, and it has been published in the form of Anne Frank. So where she was living, there in one of the main street, her statue was also made in the museum as an example of bravery, that she was really a brave example. She's really a great example of the life of the people during that time. She was a witness of the hard times of life. And this is what this chapter is going to deliver to you. Now I'm going to share with you the screen and you will be able to see the chapter. So this is the starting of the chapter and friend, right? So let us start with the chapter. Anne Frank, Amylis Mary, actual name is Amylis Mary, which is short named as Anne Frank. She was born in 12 June 1929, February or March, and it was not exact which month in 1945 she died, was a German-born Jewish girl. I told you she was born in Germany and she was Jewish girl, Jewish. Okay, of Jewish origin, and who wrote while in hiding with her family and four friends in Amsterdam during the German occupation of the Netherlands in World War II. Yes, during that time, when Netherlands in World War II, they have occupied a part of Germany, she was living in a hiding place, and at that moment, during that time, her hiding there, she has written about her life there. Her family had moved to Amsterdam after the Nazis gained power in Germany, but were trapped when the Nazis' occupation extended into Netherlands. Yes, her family has moved to Netherlands, but ultimately what has happened, though, as you have studied in social science also, that it had their occupation, it has been extended to that of Netherlands, and ultimately they have been trapped there. They would not be able to go anywhere. As persecutions against the Jewish population increase. What is persecutions? It means hostility, ill treatment, hostility and ill treatment because of political political beliefs or racial beliefs. Because people believe in different kind of racism. People believe that different races, now during these days, there is not much discrimination. Because the concept of globalization, it has been introduced. But during that time, when there was narrow thinking, people were fighting over the name of religion, over the name of races. So they, during that time, the persecutions means that is the ill treatment because of these racial discriminations, it has been increased. It has increased a lot during that time. And as persecutions against the Jewish population increased, the family went into hiding in July 1942 in hidden rooms in her father Otto Frank's office building. So where they have gone into hiding, they have gone, what was the name of the father? The name of the father was Otto Frank. And ultimately she has gone into hiding along with the other family members. Why they have gone into hiding? Because it was not a safe place for them to live in the open, because the area, it has been overtaken by the Nazis and the persecutions. It means that the ill treatment, it has increased a lot. People were not able to move freely. And many atrocities they have to face. It is just because of this reason they have went into hiding. Where they have went into hiding? In the office building of her father. And the name of the father was Otto Frank. And after 2 years in hiding, the group was betrayed and transported to the concentration camp system, where Anne died of typhus in Bergen-Belsen within days of her sister, Margot Frank. So what was the name of her sister? The name of her sister was Margot Frank. So because one of the friend, he has betrayed and informed Nazis or in Nazi authorities that a family is being hidden there in the office building, and naturally what will be the result? They have been dragged to the concentration camp. The conditions of living were not healthy at all in these concentration camps, and ultimately what has happened? She has died of typhus fever, and it is, you can say, she has died of typhus fever within days of her sister, her sister Margot Frank has also been dead there. Her father, Otto, the only survivor of the group, From the family, there was only one survivor, that was her father, Otto Frank. And he returned to Amsterdam after the war ended to find that the diary had been saved.
Yes,
he has saved the diary and convinced that it was a unique record. He took action to have it published in English under the name The Diary of a Young Girl.
Yes. This is how it has been recovered by her father, and ultimately it has been saved there, and he has got it published under the name of The Diary of Young Girl.
Right? So, as I told you that the actual name of the book was The Diary of the Young Girl, from which this excerpt it has been taken out. So, next. The diary was given to Anne Frank for her 13th birthday, and chronicles. Chronicle means when a date-wise record of the events they have been kept. It is called as a chronicle register, okay, or a chronicle. When the record of the day-wise and date-wise activities has been kept, this is called as chronicle. So, as I told you that in the diary of Anne Frank, each and every chapter, it is in the form of a diary entry. She has written with date this and what has happened on that day. So see how her diary, it has turned out to be a book, and it is a one of the great book of English literature. So this diary was given to Anne Frank for her 13th birthday and chronicles the events of her life from 12 June 1942 until the final entry of 1 August 1944. Okay, so from where she has started? She has started it writing in June 12, 1942, and the last entry was of 1st August 1944. So for almost 2 years she has been writing, and she has written enough of her life in the concentration camp, in the hiding. She was living in an annex. So there have also been several films, television and theatrical productions, and even an opera based on the diary. Yes, as I told you that this is a great work of literature, of English literature. So many films it has been made on this book also, and many opera shows as well as you can say television shows and productions, they have been developed keeping in mind the life of the girl in this Jewish camp and described as the work of a mature and insightful mind. As I told you that she has been an example, not of the present but for the future also, that during the Holocaust she was having the great hope that one day the life will be okay. So she is an example. So she is a great, although she is very young girl, 13 to 14 years of age, but still she has been a great example of insightful. Insightful means very deep mind, who can observe and face the circumstances. This diary provides an intimate examination of daily life under Nazi occupation. And what she has done, she has found an intimate examination, means she has intimate, very close observation of her life, it has been described, and how the people, they used to live a life under the rule of Nazis. Actually, it is a historical account. Her diary, it has turned out to be a historical account of her observations. So, Anne Frank has become one of the most renowned and discussed of the Holocaust victims. So, she has turned out to be one of the great survivor, not actually exactly, she was survivor of Holocaust. Holocaust means deliberate killing of large number of people due to racial discrimination. She has been the only survivor of that, and what kind of life she has lived there, it has very well been explained here. So now coming up to the chapter, let us start. Yes. Yes, here goes the chapter. Excuse me. Writing a diary is a strange experience for someone like me. Who is speaking here? Anne Frank herself is speaking here. She's saying that writing a diary is really a very strange experience. She said that writing a diary is a very strange experience for me.
not only because I have never written anything before, but also because it seems to me that later on, neither I nor anyone else will be interested in the musings. Musing means thinking. When someone sits and thinks about future and about the old happenings, called a musings. Of a 13-year-old schoolgirl, she thought that why should I write a diary? No one would be interested. No one would be interested in what I have written in my diary and what people will think about it. Nobody would ever be interested in the writings of this young girl, that nobody would ever think that what I have written in my diary, because this diary, it would not be a matter of interest for anybody. Oh well, it doesn't matter. I feel like writing and I have an even greater need to get all kinds of things off my chest. So off my chest, it means that she was feeling herself under the burden of feelings. Sometimes when you don't have any vent to give out your feelings, so at that time you feel stifled, you feel suffocated. This is what that has happened with this young girl. She said that I was feeling stifled. I have lot of burden upon me because there was nobody in the family with whom I could share my feelings, and I don't have any friends to confide in. Confide means with whom I can believe. My eyes closed. So ultimately, so what she said, that but she said it doesn't matter whether anyone would be interested in my diary or not, but she said, I am overburdened by my own feelings. I'm so overburdened that I don't have anyone to share my feelings with. So this is the reason why she said that I'm going to write down this diary. So paper has more patience than people. So what is the meaning of this? Paper has more patience than people. What is the meaning? It means that if you speak out your feelings to a person, the other person will definitely give you reaction in a positive way, in a negative way. He may criticize your points, or he may go with the flow of your feelings. But actually what it is, but paper is mute. It will never speak. It will never speak against you. Whatever you are writing on the paper, it will ultimately absorb in itself and would not speak anything about it. So this is the reason she said that paper has more patience than people, that people, they speak in return. They speak against you sometimes. But she said that for paper, I don't have this kind of feeling. Paper is always more patient than people. And I thought of this saying on one of those days when I was feeling a little depressed and was sitting at home with my chin in my hands, bored and listless. Listless means lifeless. Wondering whether to stay in or go out. So this is the point where she has explained that when she has started writing her diary, she said that it was a day when I was feeling so depressed. I was not balanced in my mood. I did not know where to go. At one point, I'm thinking that I should stay in the house. And at other time, I was just thinking that I should go out of the house. So what she has said that at that point, then I thought that I should give a vent to my feelings onto the paper. She said, I was feeling too listless. You can very well imagine that what kind of life we have spent, you can say 1 or 2 months during lockdown in our houses behind the doors, and we have also turned out to be so depressed. Although there was no war outside, but just imagine the kind of feeling that girl was having, who is just, you can say, being afraid of the outside, afraid of the surroundings also. And moreover, she was also not able to go out. She naturally be feeling depressed in the lack of the company of her friends. She was not having any friends with her to share her feelings with, and nobody to play with. During that time, some points in life come when the person is feeling too tired. too mentally sick. This is how she was feeling at that time. And at that time, she thought that because if I would share my feelings with people, the people would definitely give out reactions. They may be negative ones also, that she, which she said that she could not be able to adapt to. So she thought on that day that she should write down a diary. And I finally stayed where I was brooding. Brooding means thinking deeply in her own thoughts. Yes, paper does have more patience. And since I'm not planning to let anyone else read this stiff-backed notebook. Stiff-backed means which was stiffly bound. That means a diary. Grandly referred to as a diary. So she thought that on that day, I thought that I would portray my views in the form of words into my this notebook, which is called as diary. Unless I should ever find a real friend, it probably won't make a big difference. And till I should not find a good friend, till then I will record my feelings in the form of this diary. Okay. So here the one question that arises is, what made Anne Frank to write a diary? What made Anne Frank to write a diary? So what made Anne Frank to write a diary? Because one day she was feeling so depressed and she was sitting home in an unbalanced mood, and she was not able to make it out where to go out, where whether to stay in or to go out of the house. And that time she was stifled. She was feeling stifled with her feelings. And in that moment, she thought that she should portray her feelings in the form of diary and started writing on a diary, and thought that paper has more patience than people. Now I'm back to the point that prompted me to keep a diary in the first place. I don't have a friend. So why she has kept her diary also a great friend, or above all her friends, it is just because of the reason, because she does not have many friends. This is the reason why she has written a diary. Okay, so let me put it more clearly. Since no one will believe that a 13-year-old girl is completely alone in the world, she said nobody would believe this fact that I, at the age of 13 years, was feeling so depressed. Why? So lonely. Nobody would ever believe this. And I'm not, she said, but actually I was not alone. I have loving parents and a 16-year-old sister, and there are about 30 people I can call friends. So what she was saying, she said, I have my loving parents with whom I can share my feelings, and my sister was too loving to me. But along with that, I have a family. I have a family where my aunts are also at home, and I have 30 friends. No, on the surface, I seem to have everything except my one true friend, good time. But actually, among all, there was no one to whom I should call my true friend, to whom I should confide in, with whom I should share all my feelings. I don't have that friend. I can't bring myself to talk about anything but ordinary everyday things. Actually, she said, I don't want to discuss about some special things with that friend, but my ordinary everyday things, that one should be there with whom I should share my feelings with. Next, we don't seem to be able to get any closer, and that's the problem. Maybe it's my fault that we don't confide in each other. Actually, she said, it is not like that I don't have any friend. Of course I have friend, but actually the thing is that I'm not able to confide in my friend. I'm not able to believe completely in my friend. And maybe it's my fault. She said, maybe this is my fault, that I'm not able to develop that kind of trust with my friends. And unfortunately, they are not liable to change. This is why I have started the diary. And it is just because of this reason, in the lack of that true friend, I started portraying my feelings in the form of diary. To enhance the image of this long-awaited friend in my imagination, I don't want to jot down the facts in this diary the way most people would do. But I want this diary to be my friend, and I'm going to call this friend Kitty. So what she thought
that like other people, they are noting down the important things, some dates, some investments, what they have made. You know what the diary is meant for? No. She said, no, but in my diary, I'm not going to do all this. Okay. But in my diary, what I'm going to do? What I'm going to do? I am going to write about my feelings, the feelings which I was not able to share with anyone. These feelings I'm going to write in my diary. And this is how she has given the name Kitty to her diary. Her diary was nicknamed as Kitty. Okay. So this is all for today that we have. We have to read. Tomorrow we will continue with the chapter. So it means that today only what we have read, sorry, we have read about her feelings about diary. Why she has started writing a diary. So she has started writing a diary. It was just out of her loneliness. She did not have any friends to confide in. She thought that it was her fault only, that she is not able to write. She is not able to, you can say, share her feelings with her friend. But actually, she said she needed a friend with whom she could confide in deeply, with whom she should share her feelings. And this is just because of this reason that she has started writing a diary. And what name was given to her diary? That is Kitty. So that's all for today. And tomorrow we will continue further.